اهلا بحضراتكم في حلقة من اوكسجين فارما. والحقيقة الحلقة دي كان ترتيبها مش مفروض تكون اول حلقة، ولكن للاحداث الساخنة اللي بتحصل في الفارماسوتيكال اندستريز والتغييرات من الكارنت جوفرمنت اوف اونتاريو اللي بتخص الصيادلة وبالاخص الاندبندنت فارماسيس، قررنا ان احنا نبتدي بهذه الحلقة وبنصورها زي ما حضراتكم شايفين من قدام برلمان اونتاريو في كوينز بارك. الحقيقة في قرارات جديدة مزمع انها تتاخد بموضوع للصيادلة والإندبندنت فارماسيست بخصوص البرايفت ليبلينج. معانا النهارده ماريان كرياكوس السبيشاليست في الليجل سيرفيسز للإندبندنت فارماسيست، معانا النهارده وتقول لنا ايه هذه الاجراءات اللي بتحصل وفي نفس الوقت ايه الحلول ليها. ماريان ويلكم ان اوكسجين فارما.
يا رامي، I would like to first start by congratulating the coalition of pharmacists and pharmacy owners in Ontario. Over 1,150 pharmacists and pharmacy owners got together, drafted a letter to the Doug Ford government, advising them of the repercussions that may take place in the industry if Doug Ford does go ahead and decide to lift the ban on private labeling. And so congratulations, just like everybody in the back going ahead and shouting for their rights. I'm very proud of the pharmacy community that they stuck together and that they made their voice heard.
Private labeling, it's a new crisis in the pharmaceutical industries that hit in specific the independent pharmacists. Please details.
So basically what's happening right now and what's upsetting a lot of independent pharmacists and pharmacy owners in Ontario is that a few weeks ago, right inside this building, Doug Ford announced that he may go ahead, him and his government, they may go ahead and lift the ban on private labeling that is currently in place, which would basically put more money in the pockets of large corporations such as Shoppers and Rexall. But on the other hand, he didn't go ahead and suggest that he would be lifting the ban against rebates, generic rebates, that would of course benefit independent pharmacists and pharmacy owners in Ontario.
Okay. So what do you think the most effective way in order to affect the current government decisions about lifting this ban?
The most effective way is to keep speaking up, is to do the same that the coalition did. Write a letter, make your voice heard. A decision has not been made yet by the government, and so there is still time. And as you know, Rami, the independent pharmacists and pharmacy owners are hardworking business people trying to make a living, trying to be their own bosses and making their business profitable and making their business work and, you know, raising a family. And just like any other small business, they have their own struggles. And so they also need to be in a position where they can compete with the larger chains on a level playing field. And the only way to do that, according to independent pharmacists and independent pharmacies in Ontario, is if Doug Ford is going to go ahead and lift one ban, he'll have to also lift the other ban against rebates. And allow the independent pharmacies and pharmacy owners to compete with the larger chains. And by the way, these bans are only in Ontario. Outside of Ontario, there are no such bans and there are no such restrictions between the pharmacist and the manufacturer.
حب أكد على كلام ماريان مرة تانية، بتقول إن الحل الوحيد للإندبندنت فارماسيز عشان يخرجوا من الأزمة إنه يكون عن طريق البريشرينج. ماريان،
هو الحل الوحيد إن the pharmacists and pharmacy owners in Ontario have to stick together. They have to make their voice heard. ولازم كلهم يجوين الكواليشن و you get together to make a change.
Thank you very much, Marianne. Good luck for the independent pharmacists in their battles, and see you in another Oxygen Pharma episode. See you.